Okay, we're turning a 10-22 barrel for a flash hider. We're gonna thread the barrel, the end of the barrel, half 28 for a flash hider. So a 10-22 barrel's taper. This is a factory 10-22. It's not a bull barrel, and it's got a slight taper. So it. And I've got a spider on the back of my headstock to where I could chuck up in here with some copper pads and get it all centered up. But on a barrel like this, it's easiest just to, you've got a machined flat surface where it goes into the receiver. And then I machine out a custom plug that goes into the barrel for a live center. And that way we can turn this barrel without any elaborate setup. So the first step obviously is to turn this down just a couple thousandths under half inch, and then we'll start the threading process. I'm going to spin it at about we'll do 600 RPM, and we'll give that a shot. Here we go. Now, hold on a second. I'm going to get my dial indicator set up here so that I can know exactly. We're going to go 600 thousandths down the barrel. Okay, so I've got the dial indicator set up. Okay, you can see it right here. I've got it all zeroed. That's an easy way to know exactly how far you're going. I've also got a DRO that I'm going to zero. And that way, we're going to know exactly how far down this barrel we're going to go. Take a measurement so that I can set the DRO. Okay, that's 576. All right. And again, we're going to turn this to just a couple thousandths under 500 thousandths. DRO was showing about 506 here. Let's see how close we are. Okay, 505. Okay, $4.99. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, we're going to put the relief in it. Now I've got a little custom ground radius cutter. We're going to go in about 23 thousandths, 24, which is about the depth of a single thread. Turn the speed down a little bit. Okay. Setting my lathe up for 28 threads per inch. C, A, B, C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. and make sure we're on our 28. That looks like it. Go. Almost there. Almost. Alright, the only other thing that I want to do is put a nice little bevel on here. Okay, so I'm going to put a bevel on the end of the threads here. So I had to turn the pilot down just a little bit so that I could get in there. And what I normally do to use to put the bevel on there is the same threading tool that I use to thread it. And I'm going to spin this up a little faster than we was. So we'll go about B2, about 360. Sure, I don't hit the bluing, the parkerizing actually in this case. Looks good. Got a nice bevel on the end of it. And I know we already did one test fit, but butts all the way up to the end. Looks good. Anyway, that's about all I got. You guys take care.